Assalamu alaikum, hello and namaste. The Limelight is wishing you a happy new year 2017. So welcome to the episode 10 of the Limelight. This is Farin here. Today on the hot seat we have a lovely and sweet Lakshmi R. Nair. She is a yoga teacher in a school. She has her own studio where she teaches yoga to kids and adults. And also, she conducts free yoga classes to the tribal kids. Welcome to the Limelight, Lakshmi.
Hi, Farin. Thank you.
Welcome, dear. How are you doing today?
I'm fine. What about you?
I'm doing great, dear. I'm so happy to have you on the Limelight today.
Okay. Thank you.
You're welcome, dear. Lakshmi, before we start into your journey as a yoga teacher, I want you to give a little glimpse of your personal life.
Hi, everyone. As Sari said, I'm Lakshmi. I'm from Trivandrum, Kerala. I'm a yoga trainer. I'm teaching in schools as well as in other institutions. I used to take workshops in schools, colleges and other places. I have a son, he's 14 years old, named Nivin. I have my own studio named Lakshya Yoga. There I teach ladies, gents and weekend classes for kids also. My hobbies are drawing, cooking, then I love eating.
Yeah, me too. I love eating too.
I had completed my graduation in 2000. Then after that, after a long gap, completed TTC, 200 hours TTC in yoga. Then TTC in yoga for kids. After that, last month I did TTC in yoga for disabled children, special needs children.
Okay, this is very interesting. I never knew there is course for yoga, learning and things like that. It's a helpful information I got.
Okay.
Lakshmi, what motivated you to be a yoga trainer or a teacher?
Sari, actually, my craze and passion for yoga started 7 years back. At that time, I was suffering from arthritis, asthma and some sort of mental depression. And after delivery, I have severe back pain and put on weight. And before yoga, I was very shy to face others and all. Then I started studying yoga and I felt changes in my life, got more self-confidence. And it helped me physically and mentally to love myself, made me feel good and made my mind stable in any tough situation. So I wanted to spread the techniques and uses of yoga, which led me to this yoga.
Right. So you were suffering from different emotional stress and physical stress also, and that made you learn yoga, and after you felt the benefits on yourself, you wanted to spread that and give that to everybody else around you. That is a very good thing.
Yeah. Thank you.
You're welcome, dear. Okay. Next question is, what is your biggest strength?
I'm compassionate. Then I have the ability to motivate others. I am empathic too.
Okay.
Then, see, I'm a little bit quick-witted. Witted too, get off.
Okay.
I'm taking this opportunity to say special thanks to God, then my teachers, my friends, my cousins. Last but not the least, my son, Nivin, who supported me mentally when needed and helped me to achieve this height.
Wow, that is really sweet. Okay. Lakshmi, as you said, your biggest strength are being compassionate to others, motivating others. I think that is a strong trait of a person who is self-satisfied, who is happy within know, having the peace within themselves, only then they can have compassion and think of motivating and helping others.
Yeah, very.
Okay, next question is, can you just describe or just tell us what is yoga and what are its benefits?
See, yoga means it's a union. We can say togetherness of our mind and body. And it's a system of development of our mind, body and spirit. Actually, we can also say that it's a way of living whose aim is a healthy mind in a healthy body. If the body is physically healthy, obviously the mind is clear and stress is under control. In yoga, we use lots of breathing techniques, exercises and meditation. It improves health, happiness and boosts our immunity. Then it increases our flexibility, tones and strengthens our muscles, helps to get better sleep, detoxifies the body, increases blood flow, maintains balanced metabolism, improves our self-confidence. So there is loads and loads of their benefits. If you are saying, you keep on saying.
Yeah.
That.
Right. Because all the benefits, only a yoga trainer, you know, they know it. And different asanas have different benefits. So in my childhood, my mother used to make me do yoga. She used to say it's very good for the body. And if the physical body is healthy, then the mind is clear and stress-free.
Hi, it's good to hear from you about yoga. Such a word about yoga. If I get an opportunity to come over Dubai, I will definitely teach you more.
Yeah, you're always welcome here. And if in case next time when I go to India, I will surely try to visit you.
Okay,
let me ask you the next question. A part of yoga also has meditation, which many of them, they don't know about it. So here I want you to, you know, say me about meditation and the benefits, what they can have with meditation.
Very, actually, meditation, it's an experience that cannot be described, right? See, just as colors cannot be described to a blind person. Like that, it's an experience. It cannot be described. It's a state of consciousness when the mind is free of scattered thoughts and all. Then through regular meditation, the mind becomes clearer, motivates, more pure. It means awareness. Whatever we do with awareness is meditation, actually.
Mm-hmm.
For example, watching our breath is a meditation. Listening to music, it's a meditation. It is a state of deep peace that occurs when the mind is calm and silent. If you're saying about benefits, meditation, it reduces our anxiety. It also builds our confidence, then improves concentration, increases blood flow, leads to a deeper level of relaxation, then provide peace of mind, happiness, decreases our muscle tension, then relaxes our nervous system. So many benefits are there. As yoga, meditation has lots of benefits.
Right. Lakshmi, if you can, please do a meditation instruction session for our listeners. And I would be really grateful to you because I want them to experience that calmness. And I'm very sure only a yoga trainer, a trained person can do that. So will you be able to give us a meditation session?
Oh, sure, Fairy. I'm happy to do that.
So I think we can start.
Okay, fine. We can start. Okay, so everyone, try to sit in a comfortable position where you are. Be comfortable. For the next few minutes, I will guide you into deep state of relaxation where you will experience wonderful calmness, meditative state of mind. Close your eyes. Take a nice deep breath. Hold it and release. Take another deep breath where calmness or purity of air, love coming in, and now slowly exhale. This time make sure that you push away all internal and external distractions and negativities to feel more and more relaxed. Slowly bring your awareness to your breathing. Breathe in softly like a feather flying in the air. Your breathing is so soft. Enjoy the slow breathing. Imagine that you're flying like a bird in the air, feeling very happy, very relaxed, flying and reaching a beautiful beach. It is sun rising in the beach. Try to feel the sand. You are smelling the beach. You are happy now. You are slowly walking. You are enjoying the color of the rising sun. There is no trouble around you now. Feel the sand. You are keeping your right and left foot. You are reaching the waves. Try to feel the water. Waves are gently coming, touching your feet. You're feeling something of freshness in your mind, texture of sand, color of sky, waves. Everything is giving you happiness. Walking from the wet sand, now reached the dry sand. Mind is relaxed, flying up in the air, reaching the sky. Take a positive resolve in your mind. Bring awareness of different sounds coming inside to this place, inside the room. Bring awareness to the breathing. Breathing has come down slow and soft. Take deep inhale, slowly exhale, inhale, exhale. Now it's time to slowly bring out of yourself back. Stretch your arms out, do whatever you need. Now, gently open your eyes. Hope everyone enjoyed the meditation.
Oh my God. That was really out of the world experience I had right now, Lakshmi. I really felt I was flying. I reached a beach and whatever you say, like, you know, touching the water, waves. Keeping my feet on the wet sand, walking and then flying and then coming back. And I was concentrating on just on what you said, and it felt so good. I felt like mind was blank, it was at peace, the heart was calm, and I could really feel the breathing, the breathing I was doing. And because every day we don't feel this kind of experience where we feel so calm, and it's like almost we are being treated like a baby and put to sleep. So it was like that to me. It was really incredible. I thank you so much for that, Lakshmi.
Oh, then one thing, sorry, I have to say is that, see, there are lots of different techniques meditation.
Mm-hmm.
Always it's good for guided practice meditation because it can be beneficial because you have someone taking you through the entire process. So it's easier to keep your mind distracted from thinking. Otherwise, you will fall on sleeping sometimes.
You're right, exactly right. Because if this would have gone for a few more minutes, I think, or if somebody is laying down on the bed and doing, I think they would have fallen asleep. But I don't know, like, if they fall in sleep, what would be the next? Like, if they would be in trance state or sleep state, or what kind of thing would happen?
Maybe they may be tired or something, so they sleep. After some time, they will wake up.
Okay, so merely like a nap.
Always it's good to sit and meditate. If you lie down, obviously, most of the people will start sleeping.
Yeah.
So it's always good to sit in a comfortable position and start meditating. It will be very useful.
Okay. This was incredible, Lakshmi, as I said before. I'm so grateful that you did this session for us, for me and listeners. Okay, the last segment which we have is a parting advice to our listeners.
Okay, Sari. See, always remember that our body, human body, it is a very valuable treasure. So, it's our duty to make it protect from all the attacks which makes our system spoiled. Always follow a healthy lifestyle. It's best to start learning yoga under the guidance of a qualified yoga teacher who can lead you through the correct way of doing each technique. Do not do yoga if you are under the grip of any severe disease or something. Before doing, you can consult your doctor or a good yoga trainer. Remember always that yoga is not about touching your toes or stretching this much, that much, 98 degrees or something. It's a simple process of uniting with yourself, using your breath, body and mind. And yoga helps for weight reduction also, for weight loss also. But it's not only physically, mentally also you will get the benefits of yoga. Don't compare yourself to other students in your class. Remember, each body type is unique and different. Some might easily perform a particular yoga asana, while others may need a little more time and practice to get there. Therefore, don't feel pressurized or overexert yourself. You can improve your flexibility and efficiency through regular practice. Then, always use a mat, yoga mat, for doing yoga.
Lakshmi, you are right. Yoga is not only for losing weight but also to get a stress-free mind, and also when you do yoga, you're physically fit. And I got to know a lot about yoga and meditation today and the benefits. And also, in case in future if I want to, or any of our listeners want to start a yoga session, I think they have to consult a doctor. If in case they have some illness, or else they can also consult a yoga trainer where they will be able to get more information on which asana is good for you or what kind of yoga you can do. So thank you so much, Lakshmi, for this interview. It has helped me a lot to understand yoga better. I thank you a lot for coming and being a part of our Limelight. Thank you so much, Lakshmi.
Thank you, Fairy. Thank you all for listening. Special thanks to Smita Vinod for suggesting my name for this interview. Thanks a lot. Have a great day.
Thank you, Lakshmi. Thanks for reminding about Smita Vinod. She has really helped me in getting in touch with such a beautiful person, and I was really keen on getting an interview for a yoga and a meditation session. So I really thank Smita Vinod wholeheartedly. Listeners, if you have any queries related to yoga, you can connect to Lakshmi at her Facebook page. I will give the details in the poster also. You can see the comment section of the interview. If you have liked our interview, please do click on the like of the Limelight page and do comment, because comments are precious to us. Thank you and Allah Hafiz.